Coming up, we'll take a look at Windows Autopilot deployment, a new cloud service from Microsoft that provides you a zero-touch experience for deploying new Windows 10 devices. We'll take a look at how you can work with your hardware vendor to use Windows Autopilot deployment, and I'll show you the setup experience on a new Windows 10 device guided by Windows Autopilot deployment that gets your users up and running with everything they need in just a few simple clicks. Today, if you need to deploy new devices in your organization, typically you end up creating your own custom Windows image. You need to get the right drivers, apps, policies, and settings to prepare this image, and then you need to maintain it for every device type you support. For every new PC you deploy, you wipe the Windows that came pre-installed and replace it with your custom image, or you set up a device manually. As the IT owner, you may do this yourself or have your hardware vendor do it for you. Either ways, this costs you time as well as money and adds significant complexity and effort to the process of deploying new devices. With Windows Autopilot deployment, there is no need to reimage or manually set up new devices before handing them out to your users. Devices can be shipped from your hardware vendor directly to your employees. IT no longer needs to intercept and touch these devices. There is no need to reimage or manually prep the device before you hand it out to your user. Here's how it works. There are three entities involved with Windows Autopilot deployment. Each play a role: the hardware vendor, the IT admin, and finally the user. There are three easy steps to get it all working. Step one is device registration. When you acquire new devices for your organization, your hardware vendor sends a file containing device IDs to you. All you need to do is upload this device ID file into the Windows Autopilot deployment service using your admin AAD account and claim ownership of these devices for your organization. In the future, your hardware vendor can automatically perform this step on your behalf. Step two, create your deployment profile and assign it to your devices. With Windows Autopilot deployment, you can customize the user's setup experience and configuration by creating a deployment profile. To create this profile, select the steps you wish to skip in the Windows 10 out-of-box setup experience and choose whether the user must be restricted to a standard account or allowed an admin account on the device. Once you create a profile, you can assign it to your organization's devices. You can also mark a profile as default, so all devices automatically get this profile assigned. Step three is shipment. You can now ship your new Windows 10 devices from your hardware vendor directly to your employee. All that your user needs to do is unbox the device, power it on, and go online. As soon as the device is online, even before the user enters their organization email address, the Windows Autopilot deployment service recognizes that the device belongs to your organization and delivers a customized setup experience based on the profile assigned to the device. Once the user signs in, the device enrolls into MDM that will start pushing policies, settings, and apps to the device automatically. The user is up and running with all the apps and settings they need without IT having to physically touch the device in just a few clicks. Let me show you Windows Autopilot in action. After I power on the device, I just need to select a few things like language and keyboard settings and then connect to a network. This can be any network. You could be at home, at work, or even a public Wi-Fi hotspot. With the Creators Update release of Windows 10, the out-of-box setup supports captive portals. In my case, I'm connecting to my home network. As soon as a device connects to the network, the Windows Autopilot deployment service will immediately recognize that the device belongs to my organization and customize my setup experience. I'm directly taken to my organization's sign-in page. Note that this page is personalized with my organization's name and logo, so the device knows it belongs to my organization just by virtue of connecting to the network, all powered by Windows Autopilot. If you've set up Windows 10 before, you'll recognize that several steps in the setup experience that require the user to make decisions do not show up. Decisions such as choosing between personal device or work device, setting up Cortana, selecting privacy settings, registration with the OEM, and so on, Windows Autopilot deployment took care of those decisions for the user on behalf of IT. So I'm just going to type in my organization email address, enter my password, and that's all. My device will now join Azure Active Directory, automatically enroll into Intune or another MDM, and I'll get to my desktop. At this point, Intune can automatically push the apps I need including line of business apps, office apps, and other Win32 apps. The next thing I want to show you is the fact that the user has a standard account, just like the IT admin configured in the deployment profile. Now, usually, any user who sets up Windows using the out-of-box setup experience always gets an admin account, because that's the first user on the device. Windows Autopilot deployment is the only way to restrict the user stepping through the out-of-box experience on Windows to a standard account. If this account was an admin, it would say administrator here. So Anna has a standard account on this device. The next thing I want to show you is the fact that the device is indeed Azure Active Directory joined and enrolled into Intune for management. Finally, I started off with an off-the-shelf shrink-wrapped Windows 10 Pro Edition device. My device can automatically upgrade from Windows 10 Pro to Windows 10 Enterprise, so long as the IT admin assigned a Windows Enterprise license to my Azure AD user identity, similar to how you would assign a license for Office 365. There are no product keys, no reboots. It doesn't even need an Enterprise activation server on Corpnet. So that was a quick tour of Windows Autopilot deployment. You can try it out today with the Creators Update release of Windows 10. To learn more, check out the link below. We'll be adding some exciting new capabilities to Windows Autopilot with the next Windows 10 feature update later this year. So stay tuned, and thanks for watching.